फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू ग्लोबल ऑनलाइन। फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम इम्पॉर्टेंट एमसीक्यूज ऑन करंट अफेयर्स फॉर योर यूजीसी नेट 2023। दीज एमसीक्यूज आर वेरी हेल्पफुल फॉर योर प्रिपरेशन एज इट इज क्वेश्चंस विल बी आस्क्ड इन यूजीसी नेट 2023। दिस इज लेक्चर नंबर 1 ऑन करंट अफेयर्स एंड ऑल दीज एमसीक्यूज आर वेरी हेल्पफुल फॉर योर अपकमिंग 2023 यूजीसी नेट एग्जाम। And friends, if you are preparing for UGC NET 2023, as you all know, there will be 10 units and the units information and communication technology, people and environment, higher education system. From these three units, current affairs questions will be asked. So you need to focus more on current affairs. So if you focus more on these current affairs MCQs, it is very helpful to crack UGC NET assistant professor exam and also crack the JRF exam. And friends, to help you in your preparation, the Global Online has come up with quick revision PDF for paper 1. As you all know, there will be 50 questions on paper 1, which is compulsory for all the students. And for your revision, the Global Online has come up with quick revision PDF. In this quick revision PDF, you will get 2000 plus multiple choice questions, which are updated on current affairs, and short notes also you are going to receive. Previous year questions are available and most repeated MCQs also involved in this. And to join for paper 1 or paper 2 courses, you can contact these numbers. The numbers are displayed on the screen. You can just send a WhatsApp message and you have to pay one time payment of 699 rupees. So now let us move to the question number 1. First question is, where is the Institute of Mathematical Sciences located? Here you can see the picture of Institute of Mathematical Science. It is located in option A, Mumbai, option B, Mysuru, option C, Chennai, option D, Panaji. Yes, Institute of Mathematical Science, it is located in Chennai. So option C is the right answer. You must remember, the Institute of Mathematical Science, it is a research institute. It is located in Chennai and it was founded by Alladi Ramakrishnan, and this institution was founded in the year of 1962. This information you must remember. And since inception, members of the institute have engaged in research activities. Question number 2, which institution releases the annual status of education report ASER? Option A, Niti Aayog, option B, Pratham, option C, Oxfam International, option D, UNICEF. Yes, here the right answer is Pratham. Is the annual status of education report ASER 2022 has released by NGO Pratham. Yes, according to this report, student enrollments increased to more than the pre-pandemic level. Question number 3, which union ministry launched the statement on climate of India during 2022 report? Option A, Ministry of Earth Science, option B, Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, option C, Ministry of Power, option D, Ministry of Home Affairs. Yes, here the correct answer is option A, Ministry of Earth Science. Yes, very important questions from the unit People and Environment. Yes, Indian Meteorological Department, IMD, under the Ministry of Earth Science, released the Statement on Climate Change of India during 2022 report. So this year 2022 was the 5th warmest year according to, on record since nationwide records commenced in 1901. Yes, this you must remember. Year 2022 was the 5th warmest year. Question number 4, what is the outlay of the National Green Hydrogen Mission? Option A, rupees 1000 crore, option B, rupees 2000 crore, option C, rupees 10,000 crore, option D, rupees 20,000 crore. Yes, here the right answer is option D, 20,000 crore. The cabinet has cleared India's National Green Hydrogen Mission, which aims to make the country a global green hydrogen hub. Yes, making the country global green hydrogen hub. It is the main aim of the National Green Hydrogen Mission. And the outlay was 20,000 crore. Question number 5. What is India's rank in the Carbon Disclosure Project India Annual Report? Option A, 5th. Option B, 6th. Option C, 7th. Option D, 8th. Yes, here the right answer is option A, 5th. India's rank in Carbon Disclosure Project is 5th. Carbon Disclosure Project India, it is an environmental non-profit organization, released its annual report in 2018 and the title was Corporate Step Up Climate Action. And according to this report, 25 companies committed to science-based target in alignment with the Paris Agreement by 2018. And this has earned the 5th rank to India after US, Japan, Britain and France. Question number 6. Which IIT institute will start Vastu Shastra classes for architecture students? Option A, IIT Kharagpur. Option B, IIT Bombay. Option C, IIT Madras. Option D, IIT Indore. Yes, here the right answer is option A, IIT Kharagpur. IIT Kharagpur, India's oldest and largest Indian Institute of Technology. IIT Kharagpur, it has started Vastu Shastra classes for architecture students in August 2017. And the purpose of this initiative is to explore India's ancient roots in Vastu Shastra. And it was introduced to undergraduate students. Question number 7. When is the Sustainable Gastronomy Day observed every year by the United Nations? Option A, June 5. Option B, June 10. Option C, June 18. Option D, June 26. Yes, here the right answer is option D. Option C, June 18. Every year, 18th June is observed as the Sustainable Gastronomy Day by United Nations. And this day was first adopted by UN in the year 2016. Yes, you must remember this. And gastronomy refers to local food and cuisine. The United Nations defines sustainable gastronomy as cuisine that takes into account where the ingredients are from and how the food is grown and how it gets to our markets, eventually to our plates. Question number 8. What is the theme of the India Water Week 2022? Option A, water security for sustainable development and equity. Option B, water inclusion. Option C, sustainable water usage. Option D, water sources and security. The theme of India Water Week 2022 is water security for sustainable development and equity. President Draupadi Murmu inaugurated the 7th edition of India Water Week at India Expo Center in Greater Noida. And the 7th India Water Week will be celebrated from 1st to 5th November. The theme was water security for sustainable development and equity. Question number 9. Which union ministry conducted the Mother Tongue Survey of India, MTSI? Option A, Ministry of Education. Option B, Ministry of Home Affairs. Option C, Ministry of Culture. Option D, Ministry of External Affairs. Here the right answer is option B, Ministry of Home Affairs. The Ministry of Home Affairs has completed the Mother Tongue Survey of India with field videography of 576 languages. So here option B, Ministry of Home Affairs, is the right answer because it is going to conduct Mother Tongue Survey. So MHA Mother Tongue Survey of 576 languages, a web archive at the National Informatics Center to preserve the original flavor of every mother tongue. As per the analysis of 2011 linguistic census data, in 2018, over 19,500 languages are spoken in India as mother tongue. Question number 10. Which union ministry presents the National Swachh Vidyalaya Puraskar 2021-2022? Option A, Ministry of Jal Shakti. Option B, Ministry of Education. Option C, Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports. Option D, Ministry of Women and Child Development. Yes, here the right answer is option B, Ministry of Education. It presents National Swachh Vidyalaya Puraskar 2021-22. The Ministry of Education announced that 39 schools from across the nation have received the Swachh Vidyalaya Puraskar for the year 2021-22 academic year. So you must remember this. Of 8.23 lakh entries, 28 government schools and aided institutions and 11 private schools were chosen. And schools are evaluated for the award based on six criteria. One is hand washing with soap and toilets, operation and maintenance, behavioral change and water. Question number 11. What is the theme of the World Teachers Day 2022? Option A, Teaching Importance of Sustainability. ऑप्शन बी टीचिंग इक्वालिटी, ऑप्शन सी द चेंज ऑफ एजुकेशन बिगिंस विद टीचर्स, ऑप्शन डी लिविंग नो वन बिहाइंड. द थीम ऑफ वर्ल्ड टीचर्स डे 2022 इज वॉज द चेंज ऑफ एजुकेशन बिगिंस विद टीचर्स. सो यू एज टीचर्स वी ऑल रिमेंबर दिस. October Pio is celebrated as World Teachers Day. It is observed to express gratitude to the teachers. The theme for World Teachers Day 2022 is The Change of Education Begins with Teachers. In 1994, UNESCO proclaimed October Pio as World Teachers Day. Question number 12. Which country is the host of the 12th World Hindi Conference? Option A, Italy. Option B, Germany. Option C, UK. Option D, PG. Yes, here the right answer is option D. PG is the correct answer. Yes, question number 13. What is the GDP forecast for 2022-23 for India as per the World Bank India Development Update? Option A 8.1%, option B 7.5%, option C 7.2%, option D 6.9%. Yes, here the right answer is option D 6.9%. World Bank raised its gross domestic product growth forecast for India during the current financial year to 6.9% from 6.5%. Question number 14. Which institution released the report titled Preventing Injuries and Violence, an Overview? Option A, UNICEF. Option B, WHO. Option C, UNESCO. Option D, UN Women. Yes, here the correct answer is option B, WHO, World Health Organization. The World Health Organization released a new report titled Preventing Injuries and Violence, an Overview. And this report is going to say that injuries and violence cause about 12,000 deaths around the world each day. And Preventing Injuries and Violence, this report has also highlighted the need for scaling up efforts for prevention of injury-related deaths, which account for 1 in 12 deaths worldwide. And road traffic injuries, homicide, suicide were listed among the top 5 causes for death. Question number 15. Raitu Bandhu is a flagship scheme of which Indian state or union territory? Option A, Kerala. Option B, Telangana. Option C, Karnataka. Option D, Odisha. Yes, here the right answer is option B, Telangana. Raitu Bandhu, it is a flagship scheme of Telangana. Yes, Raitu Bandhu scheme, it is being implemented by the state of Telangana. The government offers crop investment to farmers through this program at rate of 10,000 per acre for both Kharif and Rabi seasons. The state government is also depositing 7,600 crore in the bank accounts of farmers by January this year. Okay friends, this is about our today's session, and if you want to join our quick revision PDF of paper 1 for upcoming UGC NET 2023, here you will get 2000 plus updated current affairs MCQs, you will get short notes, previous year questions are also available, most repeated questions are also included in this. So if you want to join this quick revision PDF, you have to make one time payment of 7699 rupees. So if you want to join, you can contact these numbers. The numbers are displayed on the screen. And the Global Online has also come up with paper 2 study material, where we are providing notes plus MCQs on all the subjects like management, economics, computer science, commerce, history, sociology, psychology, Hindi, public administrations, environmental science, law, English literature, physical education, geography, political science, social work, education, library science, philosophy, Marathi and electronic science. So if you want to join for paper 2 study material course also, you can contact these numbers. So the numbers are displayed here. You can just send a WhatsApp message to this number and we will respond you. Yes, I wish all the best to all. Thank you for watching.